get out of the house with that all. Be different.
Mic, please. Thank you. This way.
Oh, come on.
This way, please. Thank you.
Yeah, aggressive mood out here today. More hard shirts.
Cool outside.
Somebody close the door.
This way, please. Go ahead.
Happy Irish Day.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Go ahead.
Looking very colorful.
No poles.
You bring back a lot of bad news. You haven't discussed his findings at all in your speech.
Mr. President, Daniel Ortega says that you've lost your senses about Nicaragua.
Jake's not to know one.
Well, he says he wants to negotiate with you, not with the Congress.
He called you the top Contra leader.
I'm not going to respond.
Mr. Habib apparently couldn't find any public support in Central America for your policy of backing the Contras, sir.
Not true. I think you'll look at that poll that just came out. You're talking about public support. That's public. Pardon me, Mr. President. The question was to you. I should have asked.
I am delighted to turn it over.
But that just isn't true. I mean, there's a recent poll that we run, a perfectly authentic one, which shows the majority of Central Americans, first of all, condemn the situation in Southern Nicaragua, and secondly, the majority supports the aid to the Congress. Now, I just don't understand where you guys get this public opinion down.
But what about the Central American leaders? Why aren't any of them backing the Congress?
I wouldn't say that's necessarily so. They have their reasons as to how they express their position. And I'd suggest that you look at a speech that Mr. Duarte, for example, made on Saturday, or ask the congressman who visited him the other day what they think, or look at a statement made by the president of Costa Rica, I believe, yesterday, and see how he puts it. You've got to, you know, these fellows have code words the way we do.
Okay, are you saying they support?
I'm saying that they support.
All the leaders support.
I'm saying that they are concerned about the situation in Nicaragua, that they have, they are stating their positions quite clearly, that they understand the significance of putting pressure on the Sandinistas in order to bring them to a different approach, a political approach. I would suggest you also look at the statement that Mr. Duarte made, which has now been supported by all four of the democratically elected presidents in Central America.
But do they support?
I'll stop them.
But do they support
your show?
Do they support military support for the Contras?
As I said, they have their own way of expressing their opinions. I would suggest you look at their words. Don't take my word.
Well, what did you gather?
Okay.
He's got it. I'd be interested to know that in the Jean Kirkpatrick has a column in the paper this morning in which she's citing the figures that I believe are of that polling organization, that in some country the rate goes as high as over 90% of the people support what we're
doing. Mr. President, are you going to send Ambassador Habib to Managua?
Let's
you going to send Ambassador Habib to Managua?
Chris, I said no more.
We haven't started the meeting.
Okay, no more.
This
we've
way,
had
please.
A full press conference, and I think I ought to do it.
See you later.
Trying to find out
for
you.
And we got it.
Good.
Yes,
Yes, it is. The polling group is associated with government. It's got, it's a well-known, it's a Latin.
We're going to pull all this material together, the polling, the different statements people have made, the endorsement of the others for Duarte's approach into a little package. I hope we'll have it ready for the noon briefing in the State Department to put all that out.
Have you seen the full-page ads in the Washington Times and in the Post? Two full-page ads by some group of citizens of our own here is defying the right.
Goes back to that group that I told you about that Max Campbellman's been.
There was a strong democratic flavor to that, too.
Are we all correcting this?
Yes.
I just wanted to go about the way these fellows expressed themselves down there. I asked Duarte to make a statement about supporting aid to the Contras, supporting the Contras. He said, well, I can't say it just that way, because if I do, then I'm arguing that Nicaraguans can support my opposition. So I'm saying it in a different way. He says, I'll talk about the barrier between.
Mr. Prime Minister, hello.
Hello again.
It's good to see you.
Very much indeed.
Yes.
It's an auspicious day.
And the ambassador?
President.
Yes.
Secretary Nally?
Secretary Nally.
Secretary Donald?
Yes, hi. How are you? Good to see you. And I think I see this on your face.
Wonderful to be here, and wonderful to be there, too. Really, truly.
That's good. Well, come in. Well, you have a brief time in here.
Yes, I do.
It's a great pleasure to welcome you here on this all-important day to the Irish. And we've got many fond memories of our visit there. As you know, we're greatly in support of Margaret Thatcher's arrangement regarding Northern Ireland. We hope and pray that we can still carry on what's going on there. I noted that there in the north, the gentleman there I'm not too fond of, seems to be intent on also resisting greatly any peaceful settlement of that problem. And I'd like to hear your thoughts on developments there. How do you think we can get along?
Very much, President. First of all, they have to be here in Washington again. I think it's a very appropriate day. The agreement was there, eventually came to pass, a lot of negotiation, but between two countries, a common intent, a single intent, achieve peace and stability in our land and terrorism. The agreement is very unusual, as you know, its character. It has been strongly supported in Britain by very powerful parties, in our own parliament, by the Charlie, the Archbishop, registered so dissent. They are in the support of others in the sense that they are the power to continue to operate, to make the most of it. And amongst our people, four-fifths of our people have shown their support, both in Northern Ireland. Reckoned about 3/4 of the national population, also. The problem lies, of course, on the English side. For them, having for a century been encouraged or allowed to believe that they could determine not merely their membership in the
Yeah.
program now programs disagreement to contribution to the United States. If I may say that, that offends to any Italians or Japanese and people in the United States for the support they have given to us in what we're trying to do with the British government in this respect. It is the centenary year of the Statue of Liberty. I think we've been having some prayers and other present. This replica, carried out by craftsmen in Washington, is something that we want to give from the people of Ireland to the people of the United States, their descendants. And it seems to us an appropriate gift.
Of course, that is most appropriate and most welcome. And I'm delighted to be joined here by the Prime Minister of Ireland, St. Patrick's Day. Friendship for Ireland, the Irish people, is deep and enduring. As I said, I'm also honored to receive this Waterford Crystal replica of the Statue of Liberty. It's becoming, I'm forward to seeing you later in the day. My heartfelt thanks.
Do you think the Shamrocks will bring you any luck on the contra vote, Mr.
That's a great way to put it.
Well, this is
yes, of course, I very much indeed.